my tears are falling because summer's coming to an end soon.
I hope you folks at home, if you're hearing that sound check, we're right here on Oak Park Avenue by the VFW. And what is that song playing right now?
Take Good Care of My Baby. Sorry, I was getting distracted by all the sights here on Oak Park Avenue for their cruise night.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And then, of course, behind us, keeping up with the cool hot rod cars and special interest, we have an old Army vehicle behind us.
Dang.
It's kind of different right here, but next to the VFW hall.
Lots of different things every time you come up here to Oak Park Avenue. But with the sun beating down, we should probably get started here before I start having a drink or two.
Or three.
So grab your drinks and remember, you're hanging with Clem on Oak Park Avenue.
I was waiting for that. I really was. It's like leaning into a left hook.
Right, know? Right, exactly.
Anyhow, hey, this 56, you see 55s, you see 57s, but you don't see too many cool 56s like this one.
Thanks.
Now, I'm gonna throw this guess out there. I'm just going by what your pipe sounded like when you guys backed in just now.
Uh-huh.
Is this a big block?
No, it's not.
Wow, it's got a lot of low-end sounding bass tones.
Oomph.
There.
Yeah.
Oomph. That's it. That's the word. And the cam, of course.
Right.
Okay, so take me through the drive. Come on out.
Sure.
They just backed in and we were blocking them from backing in, so here we go. First of all, your name?
Bill McAdera.
Bill, okay, and your sidekick.
Brenda McAdera.
Hey, wife. Brenda, okay. Didn't know this was going to happen, right? So, anyhow, take me through the drivetrain, Bill.
Sure, it's a 69 LT1 with a turbo 350 and the stock rear end with a 370 Posi.
Okay, 370 is nice. It's just enough to.
Sure.
You can get on the interstate and you don't have to.
Yeah, it used to run 456 back in the day, but a little bit.
Oh,
little
that's a little tall.
Yeah,
okay,
little
how was the RPMs at certain speeds?
Not bad. No, not now.
Okay, so how long have you had it?
I've had it since 1984.
Wow, so this is your baby.
It is.
Collectively, I
think. Well, actually, I found it before I found her, so
not
long
after. Okay,
that's
a different story for a different interview.
That's right.
Anyhow, a couple of things that came to mind, the selection of color, but these original, I know it's a repaint, but it was these original colors offered in Chevy 56?
No, actually, this particular color is a 2003 Mazda Miata Red.
Really? Okay.
The color that they refer to as Vanilla Shake for the cream, so.
Okay, because you had me fooled, it's just so. It had such a nice 50s flavor.
Thanks.
You know, with it.
Yeah.
And also, my compliments in your choice of wheels. They're just old school enough to.
Yeah, new addition a couple years ago, so.
Yeah, I like it because a lot of times you will see a nice tri-50s car, and then all of a sudden it's got like 18 or 20 inch wheels on it.
Right.
Rims, and I'm just like, dude, I don't know. You know, it needs to go back to old school.
Exactly.
You know?
Yeah, we're
so
trying to get
I'm glad we're on the same page as that. Let's walk to the front real fast, and I just want to check something out. I thought I saw eyelets on the headlights. Yeah, I did.
Yep.
I think that's so cool. Again, old school looking and stuff. Oh, we're going to get the hood pop too.
Sure.
Okay. Oh, I see we have, is that a transcooler? Do you have an AC?
Yeah, transcooler.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just to keep the turbo 350 kind of
keep
cool.
Keep it alive. Yeah, keep it happy.
Okay. Okay. Edelbrock car, digging.
Yeah, the air cleaner is actually was one of my older brothers, probably from the 60s. It was always sitting in the garage, and decided to use it on here. So
yeah, I was gonna say I can't mark a period with that.
Right.
Is it good enough air with just those louvers?
It's a new addition, so we'll see.
Yeah. You know, a lot of times you'll see the 360 intake one, you know, with the filter,
right.
I suppose. That looks so cool, though, you know, but then again, is it's baby, you'll know right away when you get on it, if it's breathing okay or not. But anyhow, my compliments, either down to the hood hinges and the springs.
Yeah,
and
it's not done. We got little things here and there, obviously a little tape blocking off some holes for water coming in and until we get the rest of the trim and stuff on it. So it's a work in progress.
I like the aluminum radiator, yet it has that old school shape and look to it, to the tank, to the old brass tank.
Yeah, I struggled doing that. I wanted to keep the original with the brass, but I decided to give this a try and see.
It probably in the long run with all the use that you do in the summer months, it probably is a good idea, but you know, I'm just saying. Real fast, let's run into the back because I just want to see if there's any special treatments to the taillights or bumpers or.
No, pretty stock.
Oh, yes, it is. Okay. All right. And of course, our viewers at home want to know that where the hell do you put the fuel in this?
This one?
Yeah.
It's the hidden.
Did you see that, folks? Actually, I knew it, but I wanted to see you do it. But it's that was one of the things, a lot of GM products, 50s, and even some Mopars, I think. Everybody had a little, it was a trend to like, where to hide the intake for the fuel, you know. So.
Exactly. Yeah, you don't want to pull a full-service gas station and let them try to find it.
Yeah.
Rip off your license plate or something.
Yeah, pretty much so. Anyhow, listen, thanks for taking the time to speak with us, both of you. Enjoy this car every time you take it out. And
we do. Thank you very much.
Thanks. Take care.
All right, guys. Have a good
day. Yeah.
Thanks. My grandson, he wants to go walk down looking at cars.
Yep. Yep.
Hang on, I'm going to try this.
It's a Mopar.
I'm sorry. We walked up and these guys are hot wiring this car. We just wonder what's going on.
Right?
Well, you definitely know that the lights are working right now on this duster. Who can tell me a little bit about this awesome duster? A little bit about
that's
the drivetrain.
Awesome about it.
All right, hey, right, and it also I see a very bold sign that says "Not for sale."
That's right, not for sale. Too fast for you anyway.
Now, this is true. This is true. You see me drive before, no doubt.
Right.
Okay. Anyhow, how long have you had it?
Since 1989.
Okay. And, oh, by the way, your first name.
I'm Brian.
Brian. Compliments.
Thank you.
Original paint?
Negative.
Okay.
It was avocado. It had a slant six.
225?
Yes.
No kidding. Okay.
I delivered pizzas with this thing up and down through here on Tinley Park.
This is a great story. Okay.
I used to be at Gamboni's Pizza at 179th and
the place with a million beers.
108 different types of beer. Right. The Tinley Boot. Had my 21st birthday party there, as far as I can remember.
They had the coolest beer garden ever, too.
Right? Very nice. Bocce balls, all that, right?
All of that. I wish it was, what's there now, condos or something?
Yeah, something stupid, yeah.
Yeah, something stupid. But they had
great pizza.
Everything was great.
I delivered pizza to the World Theater when it was first opened up.
Yes.
So I went backstage to meet everybody.
Yeah.
Alice Cooper. Commented on my car and how nice it was.
Not to mention, Gamboni's was kind of a cool hangout after you left the World Theater
exactly.
on any kind of a given, whatever gig you were there for.
Right.
You know.
Delivered all the pizzas. Leonard Skinner stole beer from me.
No kidding. He's tied with Leonard Skinner.
Right.
the whole band.
Right, exactly.
Anyhow, to go from a 225 slant 6 to...
440.
Okay, 440.
Yes.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, it's seen its tour of duty and... Little
I
bit
was
of,
gonna say that.
Wait, put it this way.
Ram.
There wasn't too many Tinley cops that didn't know who I was.
I would imagine, you know. Once you did the engine transplant, did you still deliver a pizza now and then?
Negative. No.
Okay.
There's no delivery.
Pizza. You went.
I've improved my line of earnings since then.
Yes, we all had.
Yes.
The growing pains of income. You know,
right.
Through the years. So.
Right.
Okay.
Now I have a 16-year-old son who has a 72. He's not here tonight.
Okay.
Because he still doesn't have his license, but he's working
It'll
on
happen.
It.
Okay.
It'll get it in October.
Right. Quickly, I'm looking through this thing. Great roll bar.
Yes.
And is that all tied into the unibody frame?
Yeah, it's tied into the frame. We got frame ties underneath it. Everything.
Okay, excellent.
Everything is homemade. This car's never been to a shop.
Wow, hats off to you on that as
Thanks.
Well.
Thanks. Me and
to do all that fabrication, there's a lot of fabrication.
Right, this is all in 2.5 car garage.
Wow.
We even, rear axle doesn't have the normal springs anymore. It's all coilovers and ladder bar suspension.
That's heavy changes.
Yeah, well, you know.
Yeah.
You start going on the A-team over there in Tinley and talk to Robbie, and next thing you know, you're broke.
Okay, yeah, anytime you build a car and then you
find
a certain way, you do business with certain people, and
because
you want the stuff done right, you know.
This was the first mortgage. The house is the second mortgage, you know.
Okay, I can.
But you know, doing it all yourself, of course, you know.
Yeah, that
helps out immensely.
Right, and it makes for a
more of a learning experience
and
passing down to my
I've son done
there.
Interviews. Yeah, good point. I've done interviews before where I'm talking to somebody and they're going, "Oh yeah, I sent it out to my fab guy,
and I sent
it out to my engine guy, my trans guy," and I'm thinking.
Bought the roll bar kit from Robbie at A-Team and brought it home in the box and kind of stared
Figured
at it for
it
a couple of
that?
Days
okay.
and started cutting and sparking.
Wow. Anyhow, listen, great to talk to you.
Great interview
here. And also, I'm seeing some Mopar National stickers.
Yeah, I even
you definitely made it there.
I drove this car there in 91 for the first time I went to the Nationals. That's coming up in about a week and a half now.
Okay.
And we're bringing my son's Duster instead.
Cool.
He's got a 72.
Okay.
So maybe next time you're around and he's up here,
we will definitely talk to him.
Can't miss it. He's all primered still. He's still waiting on paint.
All right. And I was going to jump next door and take a look at this. Is that a Super
please.
B or a Super Roadrunner?
It's a Super B.
Super B. That's what I
go,
thought.
Go
so.
Talk to my buddy Scotty.
Yeah, let's do it if he's still in town here.
No, he's back there.
Okay, we'll sneak up on him. I'm going to grab a hand. Thank you so much for stepping up.
Thank you.
And the headlights work fine, and so do the turn signals.
Now they work.
I'm sorry, we have a schedule right now. Okay. No, it's going to be on YouTube.
She went sideways, and I was screaming at 60 miles an hour just around the highway, and it went right into it.
Hiding behind this tree
is a super bee.
Or in front. Okay, I was just talking to your partner or friend and partner in Mopar Crime over here, and of course we wanted to talk to the owner of this Dodge. How long have you had it?
3 weeks.
Wow, I'm sorry. He didn't talk to him. He had all kind of longevity, you know.
He has a time slip. He has a time slip of that actual car in his garage with my 69 Dodge Coronet when we were kids in high school.
Okay.
He still has the same car.
That's archivable now, you know.
It is. Okay. And I had to sell mine to pay off bills because, well, I think mine was faster maybe, but we don't know.
Okay. That will never be known.
And then through time, had a different car, and then just had some issues with that one. I wound up getting this one a couple of weeks ago.
This is great. First of all, was this car from the Midwest?
It's a true California car.
Okay.
It is. It's a true California car.
Great.
It has the documentation, built in California, never left California until 2000, and the guy I bought it from kept it in the garage for
15, 20
years, and then sold it to me and actually handed me the California title.
Wow.
So it's very straight.
Let's walk up, look underneath the hood, and then we'll talk about the drivetrain a little bit.
Used to be it's Coronet, so it's a clone.
Okay. You got my first question before I got the answer. But
318, air conditioning car, because it is a California car.
Okay. And all the amenities.
It was loaded. It had a vinyl top. It was olive green. So cameraman, if he gets in on the left side,
he'll catch it on the fender wall.
Yep.
Right?
If he gets it on that fender wall on the inside, we got a little flakage that shows the F5 green.
Okay.
Of the original color. And then
metallic in this paint.
All they did was an original paint over.
Really?
That's it. This is an original California straight car. 56,000 miles just as of today.
Dude, how did you find this?
Welcome to the internet, thank God.
Yeah, okay, yeah, I guess that was a dumb question, but...
and then, in a pocketbook of money.
I mean, the chrome and everything, it looks straight as an arrow.
Couldn't be happier so far, but you got to deal with California stuff, so all the electrical shot, so I've already started to... Well, we've got many, many hours already into the electrical already to...
Okay, so we got a 12 flight trans here?
727, 440.
Okay.
Still got the small little... baby rear end. So when we blow that thing up here in the next couple of months, we'll be looking
maybe
for
next weekend.
Coming up here in the next
might be days. Time for a Dana. I don't
at
know.
At the Mopar National, obviously he's got Mopar National stickers. I've got
yes, I saw that.
But this is this year's.
Okay. Okay.
Pictures on yet? No.
No, I'm not taking this one. We're taking it down.
Just taking the other car.
Okay.
But this one's going. Yeah. That's about it. She's,
Other than that, I forgot if I asked you.
Still,
I forgot.
But it's clean as can be, that's for sure. So that's a welcome to California car.
I was kind of looking at those seats, and I imagine the headliner is equally as nice as those seats.
It's as clean as everything you see, besides electrical and
blown
rubber.
Away.
It's
away.
The true California. That's the whole thing. I have to replace, this dash pad is actually it's a really extremely well done, but it's just the cover. So I'm going to take it off and put a real one on.
I would have never known that. Okay,
yeah,
but it's a good camera.
Very, very well done.
Yes,
very well done. So with the rest of it being as clean as it is, I'm going to put my Chicago stink on it.
It's a Midwest car now.
It's it. We're going to lower the front end down because it's got what they call a street freak look.
Okay.
From the 70s, or late 70s, early 80s.
You,
it's called the street freak. It was a burnout machine. It wasn't a racer. It wasn't a gasser. And it would have front end used to be higher, and they called it a street freak. That's how I bought it, was with the front end raised up like this. The guy said the guy did it from California like this, and I go,
"Uh."
It's, and when oh, I don't know, that show where they're always beating on cars. He's like, this is a street freak look. And I'm like, that's the thing.
That's the car.
He goes, that's a name. And I go, that's a thing. He goes, that's what I knew right away. That was the
some of the weirdest things originate from there on their cruise nights and cruise weekends in L.A. and also in California.
Original 15-inch.
I was just going to say, I kind of like the idea that you have these on the car and it's not an aftermarket.
Original 15-inch. Yeah. 500s.
Okay.
And
okay.
Every single person looks at them is amazed on how clean they are.
They're clean. It's got awesome offset, so the rubber sticks out in the window well.
Just like this. It's ready to show. Never seen Illinois shows except for the last 3 weeks.
Totally ready. Totally ready.
Everybody's
ready for prime
time.
And before we walk away, I'm sorry I cut you off, but before we walk away, I didn't get your first name.
Scott.
Scott, okay, I forgot if I did or didn't.
Mopar, no car.
That's, okay. Scott, before we walk away, is there anything comes to mind that surprised you when you first took delivery on this car that was like, wow, astonishing, it's that clean? I mean, from bumper to bumper, it was a shocker to me. But
the thing that astonished me is when I got it home, the wife asked me, she says, does everything work? I says, I don't know, I didn't check everything. She says, what do you mean? I says, look how clean it is. Would you check anything? I said, okay, let's do a headlight test or a light test. Well, it didn't have any headlights or half the electrical doesn't work in the car. Well,
okay.
Welcome to California. So we went and bought a wiring loom right away. So we have headlights. And
okay.
Last couple days.
I was hoping it was a simple thing like a fuse or
something.
Yeah,
no. No wiring whatsoever. All rotted away and gone. So we had to buy all brand new and put it in there.
Okay.
So that's the rest of the car I have to finish up.
That's probably experienced some high temp.
It's been fun.
Yeah.
So in his garage for the last couple days, 10-hour days, and we've got it charging. We've got headlights. We've got it ready for the Mopar Nationals. Have some fun.
This is great.
And there, we'll buy everything I need.
Yes.
Ready, available.
Talk about availability.
And slightly cheaper.
Yes.
Because you don't have to pay for shipping, and the vendors are right there. So I'm going to go and dump a dime easily.
Yeah.
But I'll come home. This car will be.
Maybe you better bring the wife with a rented U-Haul to throw some stuff
that's
in there.
That's a guy party. She don't go.
Oh, okay. Honey, that's. Forget I said that, okay? 86, that one. Okay. Dude, let me grab a hand.
Yes, sir.
It's been a slice.
Thank you.
Enjoy this when you get down to Mopar.
We will.
Okay.
All right, what's your YouTube channel?
Let me get the ball. I think he loves Tinley Park. I'm not sure. What do you think?
Yeah, okay.
And your first name?
Scott.
Scott loves Tinley Park. We heard it first right here. Okay. Well, we're going to go back and forth. Yeah, I'll tell you what. Roll it. I'm going to stand between these guys.
What's this for? What show is this for?
It's just local TV.
Which cable channel?
We're on... he's got his own... website, and then we go out on YouTube as well.
Okay.
We've been doing shows like this for how long now? AC Variety.
For a decade.
Okay. We do rock videos for bands as well.
Yes.
Stuff like that. Are we ready?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, this will be painless. I said that to the last two interviews, whatever. Okay. We're on Oak Park Avenue, and it's a great summer night here, 2022, and the cruise night, and we're trying to get a cross-reference of a lot of different kind of cars, and something about Pontiac. They're not around like they used to be, and
dying
transit.
Breed.
Yeah, dying breed. Unfortunately, amazing. I never thought they would.
Breed.
Yes, thank you. And the comments from this gentleman, I agree with too. And we're going to get their names. And you are
Kevin.
Kevin and
Jack.
Yeah, it's just
and
something. Hey, how you doing? Okay. I never thought growing up that the ranks of the discontinued would be Oldsmobile, Pontiac.
Yes.
I thought if somebody would have told me back in the day, let me grab a knee here, that this was going to happen, I would think, no, GM, are you kidding? You know, but anyhow, let's talk about these great Trans Ams that are right here. I'm guessing 78, 79? 79 here, okay. I always go by the front end where the headlights are. Anyhow, how long have you had it?
Long time, early 2000s.
Wow, okay.
Yes.
Love it. I remember when that color first came out.
Nocturne blue.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome, especially in the sunlight and stuff.
Yes, it reflects.
even at night underneath the lights, mm-hmm. it looked really cool.
Yes.
Have you done anything? I like the way it's stock, even down to the wheels and stuff.
Basically, it's where I've got it, where I've had it.
Okay.
This is basically how I bought it.
Okay. And how?
I've done interior work and everything. Don't get
me
wrong.
Sure. And obviously maintenance. And
everything dry rots and you replace panels.
I think I see a Rusty Jones sticker on
there. Yes, it is.
Okay.
It is.
For you folks at home, that was a really good rust proofing that took place back
from
in
the 70s and early 80s.
Yeah. Really.
Yes. Good old Rusty Jones. Goodbye, rusty cars.
How have the T-tops and stuff held up?
You know, they don't even leak at all.
Yeah. Wow, good success story.
Yes, they're really tight. Every once in a while you have to adjust them, but as long as you keep them well lubed, a nice conditioner on there, I've never had a problem yet for water.
Okay, mm-hmm. Okay, that's great. And the last thing, because I didn't really even look at the floor console stuff, what's the tranny in?
It's a 301 four-speed in this car.
Okay, cool.
Yes.
That's got to be fun to drive.
Yes, they're not real fast off the line like everybody thinks. They're not.
Yeah.
They're mid-range cars, 25, 30 miles an hour, then you get to scoot and go.
Okay.
Without the line, not really.
Would you agree with that? Okay, we have.
Now that car's strong.
Okay, it's funny. I was just going to jump over here, you know, because I didn't hear you guys back in, so I don't know how cammy and how, you know.
It's all stock.
But okay, take me to the drivetrain here next door.
400 four-speed.
Okay.
It's got a mild cam, and you know, it's got a rumble.
Okay, yeah, I bet it does. And it looks like I see some stock exhaust tips on there, but yep. Have you done anything with the muffler for a little more?
It's pretty much stock exhaust.
Okay, okay.
Well, you got headers.
Oh, yeah, I got headers. Yeah, I got headers.
Yeah, okay.
I forget about those.
Yeah.
Yes. It's louder when you drive. It's hot.
Okay.
You get baked in that car.
Now, the TA that was a 6.6?
Yeah, it's 400, yeah. That's
okay.
What that is.
Okay, was that a special order? Or?
No.
Okay. I wasn't sure. I was just, you know, throwing that out there.
The 400s were mostly all stock motors. Right. This is a 301 and this was a special option for 79.
Right.
You got a $195 credit if you took this motor instead for gas economy.
Okay. Yeah, that sounds about right.
Yes.
For that era in the 70s.
Area.
When they were detuning everything. That was,
right.
And
it was only 165 horsepower.
Yeah.
It ain't much. Oh.
But for what they used to sound back in the day, it didn't sound like a lot more.
But, then, but not now. It's, you know, a little tiny car outrun you.
Yeah. Quick thing, though. I never, you know, I'm jumping back and forth, but do you remember what the rear and gear ratio was from this?
The Byron has a 273 in there.
Okay, right. That's super highway gear.
Yeah, that's a highway gear, yes.
I thought you were going to say, like, 323
or 373. I put the 273 in there for highway gear because the gas was so high. Yeah. I had a 323 in there, and I switched it to 273.
Okay. Understandable.
Just
totally
now.
Understandable. Yeah.
Mine's a 342.
Okay.
It's a little irritating on the highway.
Yes. And
okay.
Yes.
So it screams a little bit in fourth gear.
Okay. It needs a fifth gear.
Okay. Overdrive or whatever.
Yep. Tremec 5-speed.
Okay.
That's what I need. Yep.
So last question. You guys make a lot of shows together. You as a team or
we're friends.
You go know, once a week or so.
Yes.
This
we
is this is golden. This is what the car culture and cruise
we
nights are all about.
From here, this is close to us. 10 minute drive.
Great. Because in looking at all the websites where all these car shows and cruise nights are, you can virtually go to a different place on the south side every night.
Oh yeah.
Yes you can. I mean, if you were looking for go on any car show any night of the week, I say the best site to go on is donspino.com.
yes, I heard somebody else mention that.
donspino.com is about the best site you go.
Okay.
For some reason
accurate,
he gets everybody's stuff.
Okay.
It's a good one. And
I don't know if everybody sends it to him, and he goes out to the places also, takes pictures of it, and comes and posts it on a site, and so you can see how all the pictures were at.
Okay.
How that cruise night or car show was.
And last question, I'll throw it this way. Have you been out to the new Dukes and Mokane?
No, I have not. No, I haven't.
Heard anything about it?
I've heard it's not bad. He's been there once.
Okay.
I've been there once.
We used to go to the old one.
Yeah, as well.
70s.
So did we used to shoot video over
the
there
80s,
as well.
Yes.
So, yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Well, with that, I thank you for you guys. I came
thank
up
you.
With you cold.
You.
I jumped in between you, and this
You're
was a
cool.
great interview, and we really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Keep these Pontiacs on the road. We got
to
educate the next generation. Man.
It's a shame. It ain't going to be happening no more. It's dying out.
Yeah.
Younger kids don't want it no more.
I didn't even want to go that direction in this discussion.
We have two kids in our 30s. They don't care about it.
I have two kids also, and they're in their late 20s, mid-20s. Same thing, you know.
My kids don't care about it.
Yeah. It's... I'm not. It's for discussion for a different interview, but it's.
It is, but you're right.
It's going to be a loss.
10, 20 years from now, it's a dying. It's dying out.
Yeah. Whatever.
Yes.
I'm already seeing Tesla show up at car shows.
That's what I'm saying.
So
how do you deal with something?
Yeah,
it's a new generation.
And it's like, oh, look at that. That's cool. I'm going.
It's
yeah.
A new generation.
Okay.
There's nothing
whatever.
You can do about it.
Yeah.
These are just dying out. Nobody wants gasoline no more.
Yeah.
Everything's going to go electric.
Yeah, I hear.
eventually.
We're going to do a special show on this too, because we all feel so strongly about it. I can go up and down this street,
well,
and we all
realize where electricity comes from.
Yes, and how you get it.
Nuclear. Yeah. They don't realize what it takes to produce electricity. It costs more to do that, but nobody realizes it. They all think electric cars. Only,
And let's charge 500,000 of them one evening.
But they don't realize where electricity comes from.
Oh yeah.
Now it's
great. You find more coal.
Yeah. They don't realize.
You can't do that.
Right. And they don't realize what the batteries. What you can do with the batteries when you're done. You know.
Yes, and
they still haven't figured out yet whether they're going to recycle.
There's a lot of caustic acids in there.
Yes, and it costs like $10,000 to redo a car for batteries.
And the last thing, if those batteries catch fire, we can't put them out.
No, that's why you have special license plates.
Yeah.
For battery cars,
Yeah.
For they can't use electronic equipment on them.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now we've more or less settled that debate. Anyhow, hey, it's been a slice.
Thank you.
You guys enjoy it every time you bring these cars out. And...
Thank you very much, Tim.
Okay. All right, stay with us. We got more coming. Okay, as we're going down the block here, and something about Little Red Corvette. I know it's an era of Vette that it's near and dear to my heart. We just found the owner, and we're gonna find out a little bit more about it. And your name, sir?
John.
John. The year?
It's a '96.
Okay.
Last of the C4s.
Okay.
Then they went to the C5s.
Original paint?
Original paint. LT4 drivetrain,
okay,
which is a Grand Sport drivetrain. 330 horse, 6-speed, Dana 44 in the back.
Wow, serious rear end.
Yeah.
What's the gear ratio, do you know?
I'm thinking it's like a 355.
That's what I'm thinking too. It's not that killer tall of a gear, but it's enough to give you some. In lower gears, it's going to give you a nice ride.
And it's
a nice
6-speed, so you could just go up.
So you had this on Interstate 80, Interstate 57, up in sixth gear. It's like an overdrive.
Overdrive. It's doing about 80 with about 1,000 RPM.
Dude, that is
super low.
That is super
great
low.
Great mileage.
That is great. That is the epitome of sports car, and then being able to enjoy it with some relief on the gas. Original wheels and stuff?
These are the Grand Sport rims.
I have the
original saw blade wheels. I got those at home.
Okay. Something about the gloss black wheels is a great set off on that car with that. I mean, it looks really cool.
Especially in the sun. It looks great.
Yeah. Well, I walked up on the other side, and the shadow side didn't even had impact, but you're right. The sun side is off the top.
Yeah. And I've got that's got a black hard convertible top.
Right, okay.
And I've got a hard top.
Okay.
Also.
Curiosity, what's the hard top? What the material it's made out of? I presume it's fiberglass, right?
The hard, yeah. It's
okay, can you just give me the weight and I'll tell you why I'm asking you that? The hard top.
The hard top is probably 100 pounds, maybe.
Wow, okay.
That's it.
Reason being, I own a 2004 Thunderbird Retro. From 02 to 05 were retro. And mine is about 80 pounds.
Yeah.
And most of that is unfortunately in balance to the back where the glass is.
Mm-hmm.
And it's definitely a two-person job with a third person as a spotter to get it up, off, and then walk it to the back of the car.
Right.
And it'd probably be a good idea to cover the back deck with a U-Haul blanket.
Yes,
definitely. You've been there, right?
Yep.
Okay.
This takes, I think there's 14 bolts.
Really?
Hold it in place.
Okay. Now, I've got a rack I store mine on, but how about...
I got a crank lift.
That is brilliant.
I lift it up into the garage
okay.
and it's hanging from the ceiling.
That is brilliant.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyhow,
yeah.
Thanks for stepping up, taking the time. Always
Thank
a pleasure
you.
To talk about a Vette, especially one that's enjoyed like this one. It's driven, but yet it's pristine. Totally pristine. So...
Thank you.
Have a great time every time you bring this car out, because it's an eye catcher.
Yes, thanks.
All right, take care.
Traditional black and red two-tone, and then they pick it up on the interior. And of course, there's the beginning day of the package, too. Thank you.
Donatella and Laura. She already knows. My husband, when we were up in Sullivan, his parents have a place in Dahlman, Wisconsin. And almost 15 years ago, we got an estate.
Sorry. No, no, I'm sorry. Is this your car? Can I talk to you about it? Yeah. No, you don't have to run away. No, please don't run away. It's a family thing. This is the second time I've seen this car, and I happen to be here tonight with AC Variety. And I thought, okay, I've got to talk to the owner. I got to just learn about this drivetrain. And then, first of all, this is a 51?
Yeah.
Okay. And your name, sir?
Gene.
Gene. And the rest of the family here?
It's my daughter, Laura.
Laura. Hi. Hi. Colleen.
Colleen, okay.
Folks, we came up. My daughter.
That's okay. That's acceptable. We're all family now.
Yeah.
No, we came up cold on these guys, and they were talking. We interrupted, but yes. You have such an awesome Ford here. We wanted to know more about it. So, how long have you had this custom?
2 years.
Okay. And kind of take me to the drivetrain and kind of what you did to it.
I did it. I bought it. Pretty much like this.
Okay, cool.
Car was built in Memphis, Tennessee.
All right.
Okay, it's got all late model Ford running gear. It's got an overdrive automatic transmission. It's a crate engine from the factory. This is the first car that engine's ever been in.
Excellent.
And it's fuel injected. It's got air conditioning, power steering, power brakes.
Creature comforts there.
Yeah. Disc brakes on front. It's got a 10 CD CD player in the trunk.
Wow. You're ready to cruise.
AM, FM stereo. New interior, all new interior.
Yeah, I'm seeing a nice choice on the color and the tuck and roll like that.
Yeah, that's it's like riding on your living room couch. It's very comfortable.
All right.
And that's about it.
Tell me about those wheels. They're really cool looking.
Those are Kragers, and they're called soft flex.
Okay.
Because they're off the old magnesium wheels from the soft flex racing days.
Right. But, and then it has that knockoff spinner look on it. Yeah, that's kind of cool.
And that is. You need a special screw, and they knock off before you can take the tire off.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Wow. Can we just walk to the rear there for a minute? The rear end and the taillights on this car are also awesome. You guys can follow.
Close everybody off, because the rear taillights are 1950 Ford.
Yeah, okay.
51, they were bigger. Plus, there was a chrome strip there.
Yes, and I mean, it was like
right
substantial.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So this has got 50 taillights in it. And then everything, trunk and everything, opens up with a fob.
Wow.
You know, and the trunk's closer to match the inside of the car. But okay. I got junk in there.
Oh, excellent, though. You got, I
and then
forgot how
the
much.
CD player in there.
Again, I love your license plate, too, to say shoebox. And then look at all the room in the shoebox style, you know.
Well, 49, 50, 51 Fords were known as shoebox Fords.
Right.
And 47, 48s were fat fender Fords.
Right.
This is the shoebox. This is the last year of the shoeboxes.
A couple of things, and educate me on this. There's a lot of nice optional stainless steel trim on this car.
That is original 51 Ford.
Okay.
Same with the chrome strip behind the window.
This is what I was going to ask about too. I've never seen this below the window like this.
It's a custom. This was, there was the only thing more uppity than this was a Chrysler. I forgot the name.
Okay.
But there was one model that was more expensive than this.
Okay. And the medallion on the chrome bumper with the
there's a secret to that, because that opens up and then that's your trailer hitch.
No kidding.
Yeah, there's a trailer hitch underneath it.
Here I thought it was just some kind of a applique, you know.
No, you open up and then you slide in your ball and then you can tow a trailer.
Wow. Unbelievable. And before we walk away, I just want to, you have some special headlight frame treatment here. I wanted to get the inside story on that. We're almost done. We're going to talk about the headlights now. Okay, bring me that is so cool, the setback, and yet, okay, what has been done to these headlight frames?
There should have been a chrome ring on the outside.
Okay.
Okay, that was eliminated, and this was all filled in with lead and steel. And these pop out. I'm not gonna pop it out, but
Yeah, no, that's okay.
But that pops out to adjust your headlight and change bulbs.
Gotcha.
You know, but that was a real big custom thing for these cars.
It is so cool.
That was like one of the big trends.
The nice offset with the light, too.
Yeah.
And last thing, I promise, but what year was it that had the one bullet in the...
49 and 50.
Okay, thought for sure. This looks much more balanced than it was, almost like the Dagmar look of the day, I think.
Well, it could be a little bit. Cadillac had the Dagmar bullets.
Yes, totally oversized.
Yeah, I guess this would be the Natalie Wood.
Natalie, rest in peace, honey. You're beautiful.
Yeah.
But anyhow, listen, I'm going to grab a hand. Dude, thanks so much for stepping up.
Glad to have
you. This car is a joy to look at, probably a joy to hang out and cruise into.
It rides like a better than, I got a 22 Ford, and this rides just
no kidding. All right, I got you.
Yeah.
All right, thanks again.
You're welcome.
We're here to see the monster pizza slice. I swear we're not stalking you.
No, I know what it is. The Italian guy, he's large.
Big guy's got to eat, man.
Yeah. Got to eat.
Speaking of which, you take a break at home and we'll be back. You're hanging with Clem at Oak Park Avenue.
I'm Suki Nikki and you're hanging with Clem.
So I'm
going
to see if I can get a shot to
do both,
but I'm
going to
wait till I get
there
to Arizona first.
It's not bad. It's not bad at all. Hey, what's up?
Look at this.
Welcome to Oak Park Avenue.
Mine?
Okay. Okay, we know him. His reputation precedes him, unfortunately.
My daughter, Alyssa.
Oh, yeah. So
oh, my goodness. Okay. I forget the thing I said about Dad's reputation.
Oh,
okay.
Of course. I'm
forget about it.
Some of the stuff I said about you.
Yeah. God, it was a close one. Is there anybody over at the tonight?
No, it's over with.
I know they're gone, but...
Savannah's over there.
Oh, that was a good choice if she's kind of taken...
She's full-time. Yeah, she is the replacement.
Oh, that's good news. Okay, maybe I'm going to pop in there sometime.
Hey, Savannah, what's up?
Okay. And as long as we're rolling and we just have the infamous Tinley Park father and daughter duo, we just happen to catch up with them. Speed is their middle name, whether it's the Shadow or whether it's this pony car behind me. Hey. Anyhow, we're going to get some names, and your first name is, sir?
Patrick.
And?
Alyssa.
Okay. Both of you are attracting a lot of attention tonight between the Shadow motorcycle, which is just killer. I love the purple paint.
It does the job.
As well as this kick-butt pony Mustang here, 5.0. We're going to start with Alyssa. Is that correct? Okay.
Yes.
Okay. How long have you had this?
I bought it New Year's Eve on 2020, so coming up real about a year and a half.
Okay. Yeah. Wow, that's one hell of a way to start the year.
Yeah, I know. How about it? New Year's Eve. So I went to Just Look and then ended up with it the next day. So.
That happens with the first look sometimes. Yeah. You know, what can I say?
Just a little test run. Bought it in Dallas, Texas.
Okay. Were you down there?
I was. So I'm stationed at Barksdale, Louisiana. So I took the drive 3 hours to Dallas and then Just Looking, came back and bought the car. So I've had it ever since. It's my dream car.
Okay. Was this something like on your bucket list?
Oh, yeah. I've been looking for this car for a long time.
Decided to fast forward it.
Yes.
Okay. Take me through. There was something that touched you about this Mustang. Take me through it.
May or may not have been the grabber blue.
Yes, for sure.
And the rims, the Recaro seats, it's manual. It's just everything I've ever wanted.
Okay, so you're a bad girl on that stick.
Just a little bit, yeah. Don't tell them how fast I've been going. But
okay, no, it's okay. I know what this car's capable of, so
yeah.
I know what the, you know. Can you tell me a little bit about the power plant? Is that the standard?
No, so far everything else is stock beyond the cold air intakes. We have our air rate.
Smart move.
Yes, yeah, okay, I love it. That,
you kicked up some horsepower like that.
Definitely. And then I've got MagnaFlow on the back, and that
is
loud. Yeah, right? Let me tell you, the neighbors don't particularly like me.
Okay.
But that's a real loud one. So yeah, that's probably my two favorite things about it. And then future plans for it, I do want to redo the tint, put black louvers on the back and then on the sides. And maybe we'll see if we can jump it up a notch a little bit. But okay. So far, I'm pretty happy with
progress.
It.
Yes, and most of these artistic cars around here and performance cars are always, you're never really completely done.
No, never.
And you do put your part of your personality in this car.
Most definitely.
Some of the things from Ford that, you know, again, this cross-member piece for rigidity, they're really good on tying key parts of the car together for stability, good handling, torque, body rock minimum. And look at you said you had a MagnaFlow exhaust system or
yes,
something?
Yes.
Okay, I just want to see what the exhaust tips
are. MagnaFlow is pretty loud.
Yeah, okay, I'm seeing the diameter is pretty big.
Yeah,
okay.
Cat back exhaust.
Yeah, okay. And so it's probably got that sharp.
Muscle car.
Really?
Yes. So the first car was a 98 Firebird convertible, same color as the motorcycle.
Okay.
And then picked out my second car, which was a 2001 Trans Am.
Okay.
Gold, silver. Looks a lot like the one over there. And then third car, picked up a 2006 Mustang, just a 5-speed manual. And then, yeah, this is my, this is my fourth car. And then the other car that I have back home is a 2002 Trans Am, and that's the last year.
So you're going between Ford products and GM still?
Just a little bit. And then for a while, I had all four cars at the same time. So needless to say, the parking situation was a little tight.
opportunity there.
Yeah, so now I've just got two cars. It's okay.
Okay. But. So I'm going to jump to Dad real fast because I've seen this bike a number of times. Never talked to you about it.
No.
Kind of heard it now and then. To and from some of the places we've been at the same time by coincidence.
Absolutely. All by accident.
Oh, totally accident. It was a shot in the dark, you know. But real fast here, how long have you had it? And
at least
what personal touches?
7 or 8 years. This bike, I purchased this from the original owner who, after having it for about 10 years, just left it outside to rust.
Don't tell me that.
Yes. And he paid like $8,600 for it. And by the time I got a hold of it, it was down to $1,700 by the time I completely disassembled
it. What did you have to bring it back from? I mean, how bad?
There wasn't a part on this thing that wasn't rusted.
Wow.
And I disassembled everything, and I just went there. Everything is hand cleaned. Everything.
I can believe that.
And then she's going to make me a brand new set of seat covers for it. So they're right now.
Very nice of you.
We got some leather and
that's happening soon. Yes.
Okay.
And I use it because gas prices stink right now. So.
Yeah, no, and it's to tell you the truth, it's just an awesome looker, and I just like the way I would professionally call that style of bike, but I like the way you sit low, and the size of the tank, and the type of handlebars on
cruiser.
It. Yes, it just has the right stance and look, especially when the rider's on it like yourself. You know, it just looks totally together. So.
And of course, I got my mascot on the front there. If you look there, you see cat dog.
Oh, okay, we got our Clem on camera is right on it right now. Okay,
right,
okay.
They're along for the ride.
Okay. And here we're just walking by. It was totally coincidence. And you turn around and it's like, oh, okay.
Wait a second. Yeah.
You know, the grabber blue caught my eye.
Thank you.
And right. And I thought, okay, we're going to, and then I put two and two together, like you on the Mustang, and it just grew arms from there. So one last thing before I walk away. That purple, is that a candy color, or is that just a deep metallic purple?
This is actually a stock Honda color.
No
this
kidding.
This is delivered this way.
Okay, because it's so translucent. Have you ever seen candy purple? It has a nice tangy look like.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
And it threw me for a minute.
I mean, I added the skull.
Yeah, on the
tank.
On the intake there.
And then, of course, dedication to her.
There you go. Is that it? Is that airborne?
Air Force.
I'm sorry, I don't have my glasses. Sorry, I had you bailing out of planes instead of whatever.
I don't know what she does for the Air Force.
I can't say.
I was just gonna say that's a had a cousin in that too, was involved with stuff with DOD and everything else, and we never knew exactly what he did, and we didn't knew better to ask.
All I'm saying is, if I'm running, try to keep up.
Yes, yeah, and that's
okay. And you heard it first here on AC Variety, so yeah. Okay.
So
anyhow.
Started or is that going to drown out the sound?
We could do it. As we were talking, that obviously sounded like a Mustang was leaving a few seconds ago.
Yeah, that
and
was,
I thought, I was thought to myself, I wonder if hers sounds like that. Shall we let her fire it up for about 5 seconds to 10 seconds and we're going to mic this? And notice the headset that Clem has got on his head. Let's try not to blow it off his head, okay?
Sounds good. I'll see what I can do.
Yeah. All right, I'm going to be back here by the pipes, and then we're going to... Oh, that sounds healthy right off. Very healthy. I'm impressed.
Me too, that's why I bought it.
Yeah. Solid lifters on there, nice and quiet, but I know that accumulates RPMs fast, so.
Oh, it does.
Yeah.
The only thing I'm not passing is a gas station.
This will happen, yeah. I forgot what the gear ratio was on these. I want to say it's around 373, but I might be wrong.
Like 373.
Yeah.
I also have a short shift throw. We're going. It's a six speed and already. So.
Okay. Now I'm surprised with the six speed. Even with 373 in sixth gear on, say, the interstate, you should be at about 1,000 RPM at about, I'm guessing this, at about 60 miles an hour. A little bit higher than that?
A little bit higher than that. Usually if I'm cruising at sixth gear and I'm, like, cruising, I'd say I'm still about, like, 2,000, maybe a little bit 18.
Okay, then that, you might have a little taller gear in the back than a 373. That's just a guess.
So somebody dropped it in there, yeah.
Yeah. Of course, you... And first and second, I'm sure it throws you back in the seat.
Oh, right? It does. Half the time when I'm shifting, you don't even need to do anything. You just let off a clutch and it already wants to go. First gear isn't involved. You're going.
Wow.
It's just, it's got a lot of kick to it. It's definitely really different from the 06 that I had. Because the 06 was just a 5-speed. It was just real easy to shift. It was driving this daisy. Then you get in this thing and we're not playing games anymore. I'm not telling you we're going. It's quite a game.
Well, folks, it's been a slice. It was a family reunion here. We kind of caught up with it. So now that there's a train in the station, too, we're going to talk real loud. Enjoy every time you're around in town and you've got this bike out and so on and so forth. And thanks for stepping up and talking. We appreciate it.
This is why I come home.
Okay. Stay tuned. We got more coming because the sun is going down. We got to work pretty fast here. You guys packing up to go?
Right, we'll just put some chairs away.
Oh no, just admiring your cars. I was going to ask a few questions. If
sure.
You're... Okay.
Yeah, but we're just throwing chairs away, that's all.
They're packing up. They're about to go on vacation here, and you know, we're gonna catch it right now.
That's because all the kids left finally. So
okay.
Okay.
Wow, I'm looking at a couple of Mopars here that are just blowing me away. These Dodges are beautiful. You guys, like, show them together, or?
Yeah, well, we're related. It's my dad.
So. Oh, this is great. And your name, sir?
Rich.
Rich and?
Rick.
Rick. Okay, this is close.
Junior.
Yeah, you're right. I went through that myself with Jim and James, you know.
If you yell Richard, we'll both look in and feel like we're in trouble.
So grew up with that, too. You know, it was unbelievable. But, okay, how long has the Rich and Rich team had these cars?
Well, mine's a 14. I got it new in 14.
Whoa, okay.
So since 2014.
Okay, what can I say? Hemi and everything else is... Take me through it. Is there anything you did to it that beyond? I'm looking at the taillight covers now.
I did taillight covers. I changed the exhaust. It's got a Flowmaster, the American Thunder exhaust on it.
Okay, so that baby's breathing.
Yeah, changed out the shifter to a Hurst shifter. So it's got the Hurst pistol shifter in it.
Is that a little shorter throw or anything, or is it?
I think it's more aesthetics than anything else.
Okay.
It's a throwback to the old school, all the old school ones, which I liked. I changed the air filter, put the cane in it to jack up the horsepower.
That works. That should work for about 15 to 20 horse.
Then I bought the chip that's supposed to unlock extra horsepower too. So
okay.
And other than that, that's about it. And then it's
no, my hat's off to you. These days, that's what you would do.
Yeah.
Again, with the power plants you got in here. You can just lightly tweak it, and you're there
it's
already.
It's not the fastest, but it's got some giddy up and go to
okay.
it.
Okay,
so.
And the last thing from the factory, what was the rear end ratio? How tall is the gear? Is it like about a 373, 325?
Yeah, something like that. It's just the standard 5.7, whatever they have in the normal 5.7.
Yeah, I figured they're posies, but I wasn't sure the ratio, and then is there like a, say you take it on the interstate, is there like a bit of an overdrive so you're not in a high RPM range?
Yeah, it'll drop. You'll get it like on the initial, you get the high RPM, and then once you hit that certain sweet spot,
yeah,
it's
then
just
going to
come
down,
back and come down. Yeah.
Okay, terrific. And we're going to jump over here because, not to sound dumb, but what edition is this?
Mine's a 16.
Okay.
But it's a Challenger. It's a 6.4 liter. It's a Scat Pack.
That's where I was after. I saw the badging on the side.
Yeah, it's like the Super B.
Exactly. Yeah. And I thought to myself, I'm not going to go up and ask him, is this a Super B? Because I'm going to make a fool out of
myself.
Yeah, it's
the same. Yeah, it's
but then again,
yeah.
It's a retro.
Yes, it's
yeah.
A throwback. You know, it's yeah, a throwback. Yeah. I'm looking at the medallion. I'm going, I'm having a 1969 flashback here,
yeah,
well, you know.
This actually has the biggest Hemi they make.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a 6.4, but it doesn't have the turbocharger on it. So it's only like 500 horsepower. The turbocharger is 1,000 horsepower, so it's a big difference. But mine's a stick.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't have an automatic.
This is going to be a fight. Let's walk up. Can we walk up? Can we walk up to the front of the car? At least to help us out with the railroad going by. Yeah, I wanted to see, is that a special cold air?
Yeah, it's a special racing team.
Okay.
Like I said, it's the biggest Hemi they make, except the only thing it doesn't have the turbocharger, which would bring it up to like 1,000 horsepower.
Right. How is this handling and accelerating?
Great. It's the Scat Pack, so it's got a better suspension.
Okay.
It's got a better exhaust system.
Okay.
It's really loud. Yeah. It's
now, did you, like your son, he modified the exhaust.
I didn't do anything to it. I bought it just the way it is.
Okay.
And it's a 16. I bought it from a guy that actually was a manager at the place that Dodge.
I mean,
it sat on a lot for a year.
It only had
2,200 miles on it when I bought it.
Okay, because I the World of Wheels, I talked to a guy that had a limited edition like that at one time, a Challenger. He said he had to wait a long time.
Yeah, well, nobody could buy it. I guess he said young kids look at it, they don't know how to drive stick. And plus, they couldn't afford it.
I was just going to say,
they said the
price
older guys
range,
liked the price, but they couldn't drive stick.
Okay.
But I said, I drove stick my whole life.
Yeah,
so
yeah. Yeah, you were born with it. Okay.
Well, I told him, I said, if it wasn't stick, I wouldn't have bought it.
There you go.
Yeah.
That's old school muscle car,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, it had to be a stick shift.
Yeah. Anyhow. Listen, thanks, you guys. I know you're getting ready to pack up, go home, but
no.
I'm walking a lot, and I thought, God, these cars are just too bad.
We're
gotta
mostly folding up, like I said, because the kids left, so we're
putting
our chairs.
Sure, and I can understand how that all goes, too. So. Anyhow, listen, enjoy these babies every time you roll them out.
Oh, yeah.
They are definitely crowd stoppers, you know?
Like I said, I only got 3,000 miles on it, so I had it for three years now. Yeah, I didn't even put 1,000 miles on it yet.
Wow.
It's just in the garage. It comes out for the car show, that's it.
Yeah, and it's
the only time it comes out.
That is the richest black, too.
Damn. Except, you know what, he left it out for a year in the lot, so there's a lot of water stains on it, so I'm going to get it out there and get it popped out.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's sat in the park. Yeah, it sat in their lot for almost a year.
God, I'm surprised they couldn't find a spot inside for the damn thing. They even put it in the showroom.
One of the managers at the place owned it. He never drove it. He couldn't sell it.
Wow.
Like I said, nobody wanted it because it's a stick. And like I said, the young kids wanted it, but they couldn't afford it.
Yeah, and it's out of their range. One thing before I walk away, too, what do you do with this over the winter?
Store it in the garage, cover it. You know,
the usual routine.
Yeah. Okay. Trickle charger on it. Just let it sit till the summer comes.
Yeah, you got it. Yeah.
And it'll see rain or snow.
No, it is.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Yeah. And no reason to.
That's why it stays that clean in there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You show ready all the time, guys.
That's right.
All right. Be blessed. Enjoy
Thank
these
you.
Cars.
Stay safe.
You bet.
Take it easy.
36,000 to 24,000 miles. Huh?
It's pretty cool getting low to the ground to see all the cars pull out over here.
He was crawling.
I had a wonderful time here, hanging with myself on Oak Park Ave. What about you, James?
Great time. Anytime you do the Tinley Park Cruise Night during the summer in 2022 is no exception. It is a great time, great metal, great cars. What can I tell you, man?
I'm sorry, that was vain of me. I enjoyed hanging out with you.
I kind of like the cars. Anyhow, hey.
And our new friends. It's always a fun time. You never know what you'll run into, including a Mustang from Arizona.
Yes.
Which this might be the only time it's ever interviewed in the Chicago area, so I'm being like a lucky guy. But it's hot out here. Sun's going down. I'm going to grab a drink. You grab something to eat. And until next time, remember, you're hanging with Clem. I'm Clem. Who are you?
I'm Jimmy.
And you're hanging with me. See ya.